In this very quick video, I'm going to show you a basic overview of getting started with Flipgrid. So first you'll go to flipgrid.com and it'll bring you to this screen right here. If you've never created an account before, you can create a free account and then just enter in the required information to get started with Flipgrid 1, which is free. And then you would just press create my grid. Now, since I already have an account, I will go to teacher admin. And that brings me right to my account that I have right here. So if you have a free account, that means you'll just be able to create one grid. I have a premium account right now, so I have multiple grids. But don't worry, all you really need is one grid to get started with this, because within a grid, for example here, you can see that I can have a lot of different topics. So I can have a lot of different topics for a lot of different classes if I want. So I'm just gonna show you an example. So I'm gonna do a new grid. And here you just fill out the required information. So you need a grid name. If you have the free account, you might just make it your name's classes. You can optionally give your grid a purpose. Then you just have some settings. So choose what you want on, what you want off. From here, you just have a background image. You can upload your own, or you can just choose from the ones that Flipgrid already has. So they have the featured ones. They also have more if you go into nature, for example. I'll choose that for this one, and then I'll press create grid. Awesome, my grid is ready. So here's where you can create the topics. So that's what you'll be doing the most of. Creating the grid will be a one-time thing. You do that once. Then as an ongoing basis, you can create new topics and think of those as like little prompts that you want to give your students. So prompt number one, if you are on the free account, you'll just have the 1 minute 30 second option or a 15 second option if you want students to create a really quick little snippet. If you have a pro, you'll get more options. Then just give a little question or stimulus text for this topic, what you want students to be recording about. Visible, frozen, and hidden. Visible obviously means that this is visible and students can record to it. Frozen means that students can view, but they cannot record anymore. So after something's over, you might freeze it so that new people can't record to it. And then hidden is just hidden. You can also add topic resources. So maybe you want to record a video to prompt students so that they can see you talking. You can record that. You can also upload a video. Maybe you have a YouTube video. You want students to watch that and then respond with their reactions, for example. You might want to upload an image. So you want students to talk about it. An image that you've uploaded. So there are multiple options that you can add a topic resource. You can also add a topic attachment. Say, for example, you're doing a deep dive into a reading. You want students to read something first. You can go ahead and just put that URL right there, and then that reading will be attached to your prompt. In addition, you can attach a Google Doc. Say you have more directions you want students to read ahead of time that you can't really fit into the prompt. You can go ahead and put that there. Anything that you've attached here will be displayed on the topic on your main prompt. Finally, response features. So you can have students decorate their selfies at the end after they've recorded their video. They have to take a little selfie, and that is like their identifier that will post on the grid. You can allow them to mark it up with stickers and drawings, stickers only, drawings only, or none. That is a new feature. Response moderation, you can turn on or off now at the topic level. So this is just for this specific prompt. You can choose if you want to turn response moderation on. An idea for using response moderation: if, for example, you want everybody to post a reply before seeing anybody else's, you could turn on response moderation. And then after the due date for that initial post, you can go ahead and just accept everybody's responses, and then everybody's responses will show up on the grid. In that way, nothing will have shown up until everybody's posted or that due date that you requested. And then you would approve all the responses. They would show up on the grid. You could have students go back in and respond to what their classmates have said or do some other activity. Replies to responses, those are only allowed if you have a premium account. A way around being able to reply directly to a response is just to have students make a new prompt on the grid itself. So it's not really that big a deal to have this option or not. Response reactions, students can now respond with emojis. So that's kind of like this. They can react to videos that their classmates have posted, and that could be a fun way to engage students with appropriate emojis. You can also require email for responses. It's nice to require emails for students' responses because that allows them to go back and delete a video if they need to, and they'll also get an email alert to their post with the link, and it can just help them keep things organized. So I do recommend that you keep that on. Response title is also something new. Students can now put a title to their response. It's optional, but using that could be a way to increase searchability within grids. Feedback, if you have the free account, you'll only have the option to do basic feedback, which will allow you to provide basic feedback on performance and ideas. And if a student has put in their email address, then it just sends that feedback back to them via email. You'll also have a little bit of room to write a comment in there. After that, you'll just create your topic. I just recommend using this direct link to the topic right there, posting it on Haiku or your learning management system for students to be able to view. And then that's it. Students would just hit this big green plus sign to add a response to this grid. Hope this quick overview that turned a little bit longer than intended was helpful for getting started with Flipgrid.